Yo, it's your boy Young Mully. Now check this shit out, man. Manchester City just pulled up to Paris with the League Cup strapped up to the Louis bags, still high from the victory on the weekend, and got the job done on a rainy day in Paris. Now, the last time those two sides met in the Champions League was in 2016, where in the first leg it finished 2-2 in Paris, Ibrahimovic and Kevin De Bruyne scoring that game. Now, the game started with high tempo and PSG, especially after the 10 minutes. I'm not gonna lie, man, they looked really good. City looked surprised and shocked by the intensity PSG had. Neymar was straight up on some motherfucking smoke. It looked like the City players were afraid to tackle him and get tied to him. Now, PSG bright start was rewarded when Marquinhos scored from a corner, and thus becoming only the third player in football history to score in the quarterfinals and the semifinals in 2 years in a row. Now, Di Maria has now either assisted or scored all the goals PSG has ever scored in the semifinals in their Champions League history. The trio of Mbappe, Neymar and Di Maria looked like they was gonna rip the City defense the whole night. Just in the first half, Mbappe alone created more chances than the whole City team combined. Now, hella people were on Mbappe's dick after the game, and that's because in the second half, the young Frenchman went straight up on some flight mode, but we'll come to that later on. Now, shout out to Guardiola, man. At halftime, all pundits were crying saying Pep should put a striker on. The great Arsene Wenger himself said at halftime, Manchester City are suffering from their system. No striker, so always they're playing sideways, no running behind of the defense, and nobody can play to. But Pep knows, man, stop playing with this homie, man, stop playing out here, man. The homie kept faith on the soldiers he had on the pitch, and that paid off, man. Now, in the second half, it's kinda hard to say whether it was Manchester City that stepped up their game, or is that PSG got too confident and started lacking in the second half. I think it was a combination of the two, because Manchester City definitely turned up the screw while PSG got sloppy possession, their intensity dropped off and their performance was so opposite from the first half. In the second half, they just had one shot compared to 9 in the first half, and the pass accuracy dropped from 90% to 86% and the possession dropped from 49% to 41%. Pep said in the post-match interview in the second half PSG couldn't breathe, and that's true, man, these motherfuckers were choking on the silly dick, you know what I'm saying? Pause. In the Champions League, you really can't afford to lag for a minute, let alone for 45 minutes, because at this stage of the competition, only the real killers are left and one mistake can cost you a lot. Now, I know a lot of people expected a lot from Mbappe, but to be fair to him, in the second half, he barely got any service, but the homie really didn't help himself either as he wore his invisible cloak for the whole of the 45 minutes. By the end of the game, Keylor Navas and Ederson had more touches of the ball than Kylian Mbappe. Navas almost had twice the touches of Mbappe had, man. And that's some bleak shit because these motherfuckers are just goalkeepers out here. Now, Mahrez, the homie that grew up in the trenches of Paris, was one to give the final blow to PSG after Kevin De Bruyne scored a freaky first goal. I know many will say it was a lucky goal, but the real ones out there, they know KDB has done that a few times before. And actually, by the way, while we're at it, man, what's up with the wall for the Mahrez free kick? That bitch just opened up. That free kick from Mahrez wasn't even that great, and if the wall had done his job, this game would have ended 1-1. Manchester City are now the first Premier League team to win 10 plus Champions League games in a single Champions League season since the current format was introduced in 2003. Kevin De Bruyne is the first Manchester City player in history to score in the Champions League semi-final for them, so congrats to him on that shit. And if you're keeping it real, man, the game really wasn't a classic, but nevertheless, the gas oil money teams both showed they really wanted it. And this time, even though City have an advantage now, it's far from over. Y'all already know Mbappe and Neymar ain't gonna go out without a fight like that. In the last 45 games, only Bayern Munich has kept PSG from scoring a goal in the Champions League, and we can be confident next week at the Etihad, PSG will find a way to score a goal. Hopefully it will be a more open game than this one, because PSG will now need at least 2 goals to go through to the final, but once again City gave a footballing lesson to all of us how to defend with the ball. Anyways, do y'all think PSG has what it takes to mount a comeback next week? Let me know in the comment box. It's your boy Yamuli. Like and subscribe. Shlick.